Hi everyone, my name is Gerda Hebba and I'll be interviewing Jenn Bojm and Khingfisher today. For those of you who don't know, Jenn Bojm and Khingfisher are a duo from Vancouver, BC. Their debut album, The Symphony Club, features stripped-back, slowed-down folk covers of songs from artists like Bob Dylan, Emmylou Harris, and Richard Farina. They were recently named one of Vancouver's best bands by the Georgia Strait, and they'll be opening for Tommy Emmanuel this year at the Jazz Festival, June 25th at the Vogue Theatre. So be sure to come out and see them. Hi, how are you guys doing today?
Good.
Good.
Good to have you here. We're really looking forward to your performance at the Jazz Festival. This will be your first time performing together at the Jazz Festival?
Yes.
At the Jazz Festival,
yeah. Festival, yeah.
Great, that's so exciting. So you just released your debut album in 2016, and I'm a huge fan of it. I love folk music, so hearing your guys' rendition of all of these songs in a folk way was amazing. And speaking of that, some of the songs you covered on the album are folk songs, but some of them are not. So I was wondering, like, why folk music? What drew you to doing folk renditions of these songs?
We enjoy the storytelling aspect of folk music, and we were just kind of sorting through some songs and bands we liked that told cool stories, and we wanted to kind of do our own version of it, kind of slowed down and really relaxed.
That's awesome. Good to hear that. And so what inspired this project of digging up the old treasures and, like, rediscovering songs that people may have forgotten about?
It was really just for fun. We just kind of got together and we're learning a couple songs together, which we had done a number of years ago too.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was really just for the love of the storytelling and of looking for interesting songs that were well written and crafted and playing around with them.
Yeah.
And eventually we had a chunk of them, so we decided to...
Yeah, kind of started with a couple and it snowballed from there, and then we ended up
with
enough to make a record.
Well, it's beautiful to see what you guys have done with it, and just, like, from what you hear nowadays, like the manufactured pop songs, it's nice to also hear something that has more of that storytelling aspect to it, because you don't really hear that in, like, the overly produced songs, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Goes the other direction.
Definitely
has a place in this world for some people.
Yeah. And so why did you pick the songs you did? Were they songs like you already enjoyed listening to, or were you kind of looking for a certain criteria in the songs you picked? Or
some of them were songs we listened to a lot, like the Ink Spots one on there is just one of my favorite records, just kind of like listening to it. And some of them we were just searching and trying to find new music to listen to as well. Like, I hadn't heard of Richard and Mimi Farina before this project. Like, Jen kind of turned me onto that.
Yeah,
and again, it was looking at narratives, like interesting narratives we found in songs, and ones that really spoke and had a sort of depth of poetic to them too. So
that's awesome. How did you guys do that? Did you, like, dig through, like, vinyls or
good old
Google search?
Some vinyls, some just, like, shooting each other YouTube links and stuff like that.
That's
seeing
cool.
Kind of what stuck.
Probably a fun process for sure.
Yeah, some of them are just ones that were in our minds or from our past, or from just the ones that stuck with us over the years. So
that's beautiful. Mm-hmm. And speaking of your upcoming performance at the Jazz Festival, what's your program look like? Are you guys going to play songs from the Symphony Club or some new songs you're working on?
We'll be playing some from the first album, but we've also been working on writing some songs now. That we've done this record, we realized we really enjoy playing music together, and we've started writing together now, so we'll be performing some of the new stuff for writing as well.
Awesome. And the new stuff is completely original, or is some more covers in there too?
I think there's
one cover on there,
one cover that we're working on, and the rest are all original. So
beautiful. And I imagine in a folk way again.
Kind of psychedelic folk a little bit. I'm playing electric guitar more these days. So.
That's awesome. Do you guys know when that will be released, or are you just kind of
finding
it all out now?
We just started recording it currently in my attic. So
okay.
We're going to kind of piece it together hopefully this year, and then
we've started working on it.
Kind of takes a while to press vinyl, so probably more so early next year, I'd guess.
Great. Well, we're looking forward to it. And I know that you are in some other projects beside this duo, so do you mind telling me a bit about them?
Yeah. So, well, especially for the Jazz Festival, I play bass in Colin Cowan and the Elastic Stars, so we're going to be doing that on June 24th.
Mm-hmm.
And then singing with the Sunra Star System, which is also on the 25th. Yeah, those are kind of the mainstays, yeah.
It's funny because we have access to, like, all the collateral, obviously, like the artist photos and the videos, and I was looking at your photo from with Colin Cowan and the Elastic Stars, and you're wearing like these tight, like silver, like metallic pants, and then there's this different side of you. So
yeah, it's definitely
yeah,
a different vibe.
Yeah,
so.
I love it. It was like so interesting to see that, you know, that other side of you,
well,
and it's
yeah. I used to play solo, and Colin would play bass with me, and he
mm-hmm.
said. He said it's not fair if I'm playing bass with you, so you have to play bass with me. But at the
yeah.
time, I had never played bass before, so since then he's taught me how, and so it's been probably
yeah.
about 3 or 4 years now that I've been playing, and it's been really fun.
That's amazing. And in this duo, you both play acoustic guitar, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and some electric guitar plays.
Nice. I'm looking forward to hear, like you said, you're just messing around with electric guitar now. I'm looking forward
yeah.
to hear that transition in the next album.
Yeah, there's some songs on the previous album with electric guitar, but I really kind of like the sound of them, so I'm doing
yeah.
a bit more for this one.
Yeah, it's nice to change it up and see what you can do with it. And my last question is, if you could describe your duo in 3 words, how would you describe yourself?
Laid back gleaners.
Yeah, that's
I like
words.
That.
It's true.
Do you guys have any last comments or perhaps want to let the audience know where they can find you on social media?
Yeah, we have a Facebook page, which is just in Jenn Bojm and Khingfisher, and we've got an Instagram, same name, and
Bandcamp, same name.
Bandcamp.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Right, well, be sure to look them up and don't miss their performance June 25th at the Vogue Theatre. Thanks, everyone.
Will